Hello everybody, so once again you are with me and we are talking about the biology as usual. So in which chapter we were talking about? We were on the chapter anatomy of the flowering plant. So in the anatomy of flowering plant we were talking about the tissues, right? And in the tissues we were talking about the different kind of the tissues, different permanent tissues. In the previous class, we are completed with the, in the just previous sessions which we have completed, we were talking about the permanent tissues and the simple type of permanent tissues. Different tissues such as sclerenchyma, collenchyma, parenchyma, we are done with that. Now it's time to study about complex permanent tissue. Let's start the topic. Complex permanent tissue. So, listen to this. First of all, what exactly this complex permanent tissues are? In this topic, in this subtopic, we will be talking about the xylem as well as phloem. Complex permanent tissues, as the name indicates, complex. Complex means they are not made up of only single type of cells, they are made up of multiple type of cells, right? So they are heterogeneous type of cells. Not only these, they are also vascular and conducting type of tissues. For example, we have a xylem, we have a phloem. Xylem help in conduction of the water and whereas a phloem help in conduction of the food. First of all, we will start with the xylem, then we will proceed towards the this phloem. So, when we talk about the xylem, what exactly this xylem is and what exactly this phloem is, let's understand this, then we'll start writing. So, we are talking about the xylem. Xylem and the phloem, they are both made up of procambium. After this vascularization, after this differentiation, they form xylem and the phloem. So, let's start the topic, xylem and phloem. So, what are complex permanent tissues? Complex permanent tissues are made up of more than one type of cells. That's why they are called as a complex type. Now understand this carefully. We are talking about the complex. I've told you that they are made up of cambium, right? So procambium differentiate into primary xylem and primary phloem. Some of these things might be very much confusing to you. So initially, the formation of these complex permanent tissue, they start with procambium. The vascularization, the differentiation, vascularization that leads to the formation of primary xylem and the primary phloem. Now, what exactly these xylem and the phloems are? Xylems, they help in, these are vascularized. Let's write first. Xylem are, and xylem and phloem both. Are vascularized and conducting tissues, right? Xylem and phloem are vascularized conducting tissues. And they are mostly dead tissues. So, complex permanent tissue, I've told you, they are dead tissues. some are mostly, I am talking about the mostly, they are dead. When I will be talking about the xylem, I will be telling you that what kind of the xylem they are alive and what are the different kind of the xylem which are dead. So, they are mostly dead tissues, because dead tissues can easily conduct these food as well as minerals as well as water, right? So, these are the complex permanent tissues, and we have discussed the xylem. We have to discuss the xylem as well as phloem, right? Now, let's start the xylem first. Xylem. Now, what is a xylem? Xylem help in conduction of water from where? Not only water and minerals also. So, understand, first of all, understand this very carefully. We are talking about the xylem. Xylem help in conduction of the water and the mineral. More the easily conduction of these if they are dead. Dead tissues can conduct water easily. Dead tissues can conduct water easily. So, we are talking about the xylem. Xylem, they are made, basically there are two types of xylem. One is called as a primary xylem and another is called as a secondary xylem. Primary xylems, they are those xylems which are formed first, whereas the secondary xylems, they are those xylems which are formed after the secondary growth. Similarly, the primary xylem, they are made about, you can say in the primary xylem, we have further two types. One is called as a proxylem, and another is called as a metaxylem. So, we will be talking about all those things. So, on the basis of origin, xylem is of two types. Right? So, xylem is of two types. What are these names? The first one is called as a primary xylem. And the second one is called as a secondary xylem. Secondary xylem, as the name indicates, that means they are formed at the time of secondary growth. Primary xylem are those which are formed first from the procambium. So, the primary xylem and secondary xylem. Let's discuss about the primary xylem first. Now, primary xylem, they are those xylem which are formed by vascularization of the procambium. What are these? Primary xylem formed by vascularization of procambium. Another feature of this primary xylem is that they are formed first. Primary xylem formed first. Right? So, this is called as a primary xylem. Primary xylem is further divided into the subtype. Let's talk about them. P primary xylem are divided into two types. Now, tell me what are the name of these two types? We have discussed that. So, first type is called as a protoxylem or proxylem. Protoxylem. Now, understand this very carefully. First, I am talking about the primary xylem. They are formed by the vascularization of the procambium. They are the first formed. In that first formed, those xylem which is first formed in the beginning. This is the first form. This is called as a protoxylem and they are smaller in size. Later on, as this differentiation proceed, another kind of xylem they form, that is called as a metaxylem. So, what are protoxylem? These are small cells. Small cells. And another feature is that they are formed first in development of xylem. Right, this is called as a protoxylem. So, what we are discussing? We are discussing the conduction of the water, and the vessel which is responsible for the conduction of water is called as a xylem. Xylem help in conduction of the not only water but also the minerals. So, on the basis of their origin, I have divided these into the two types. The first type is called as a primary xylem and second is called as a secondary xylem. We have started with the primary xylem first. They are formed by the vascularization. They are vessel-like structure, a long tubular structures we can see. So, they are conducting system. They are actually a conducting system divided into the protoxylem and the metaxylem. Now, let's discuss about the metaxylem. So, we are done with the protoxylem. Let's start with the metaxylem. So, metaxylems, the cells are large. And they are formed later in vascularization. Formed later in vascularization. Vascularization, right? This is a metaxylem. So, we are done with the primary xylem. Now, let's talk about the secondary xylem. So, secondary xylem. Secondary xylem. Secondary xylem are those xylem which are formed during the secondary growth. So, what else I can write? They were formed by the procambium, whereas the secondary xylem, they are formed by vascularization of the cambium. Already we have a cambium, the cambium is developed. Now it's time to form the secondary xylem. And similar process formed by vascularization. Vascularization of cambium. And when they are formed during secondary growth. They are formed during secondary growth. This is called as a secondary xylem. Now, we are done with the type of the xylems. The main functions of these xylem. Let's talk about the different type of the xylem which is present inside the cell. So, let's talk about the types. This was on the basis of origin. Now, on the basis of structure, the xylem is of following type. Let's talk about that. On the basis of function and structure, xylem is of four type. The first important type is the tracheid. Tracheids first. Second is called as a vessels. Third one is called as a xylem fibers. And the fourth, very important, is xylem parenchyma. Xylem parenchyma. So these are the different types. The first question from the session is spring wood is. Now there are generally two type of wood generally present. On the basis of their nature, mostly two types of woods are present. First is a spring wood and next is a autumn wood. Spring wood and autumn wood. Spring wood is generally lighter in a color and hence the low density, whereas the autumn wood is a darker in a color and a higher density, where in the case of spring wood there is an absence of a cambium, and in the autumn wood sometimes there is an absence, or we can say less active of a cambium in a winter season, hence there is an activation of a xylem elements in the case of autumn woods. When we consider the case of only wood, the spring wood is lighter color and low density. Lighter color and low density, whereas the autumn wood is darker color and high density. This is all related to this question. Let's again discuss the question. The question is spring wood is. Now the spring wood, there are four options. Option A is a light color and a light density. Option B is a light color and a high density. Option C is dark color and a less density. Option D is a dark color and a high density. As according to the discussion, we know that spring wood is generally light in color, but high density is related to the feature of a autumn wood, not with the spring wood. And when we consider the dark color is related to the autumn wood, not for the spring woods. Again, for the autumn wood, less density is not the feature. So option B, C is the wrong one. Next, option D includes dark color and a high density. This is the feature for autumn wood. Autumn wood, not for the spring one, and our question is asking for the spring one, not for the autumn one. So the option D is the wrong one. The right option is the light color and the less density. It means generally, as according to the discussion, spring wood is generally lighter in a color and hence they have processes the light density as compared to the autumn wood. So the option A is the right one in this case. Let's discuss the next question. The next question is, select the correct pair among the following. Out of four, we have to check out the correct pair. Option A includes spring wood, which is generally showing light color and a high density. Option B includes spring wood, includes dark color and a low density. And option C, that is a autumn wood, includes light color and a high density. And option D, known as a autumn wood, includes dark color and a high density. as according to the discussion of a wood, as we discussed earlier in a first question, wood is categorized into two main types, spring wood and autumn wood. As we consider the case of a spring wood, it is generally lighter in a color and possesses low density, whereas autumn wood, we consider the case of autumn one, they are generally darker in a color and possesses high density. This is all the basic presence, or we can say the feature of the wood that generally occurring in a two forms, spring one and the autumn one. Let's again discuss the question. The coin out of four option, or we can say we have to check out the correct pair. Out of four, the option D1 is the right one, because it contains both the properties which is resembles, or we can say for autumn wood. First is a dark color and next is a high density. Option C includes the autumn wood, and autumn wood we know it includes darker color and a high density, but there is a showing of a lighter color, hence this option is also wrong one. High density is the right for the autumn wood. Next is a spring wood, they are generally darker color. No, this is the wrong one, because when we consider the case of spring, it includes the lighter color wood, not the darker one, and low density is the right option for the spring wood. So the option B and C is the wrong one, because it contains the opposite color for the autumn and the spring one. Option A includes a spring wood, that is a lighter color and high density is the feature for autumn wood, not for the spring one. So option A is also wrong one. The right option is option D, that includes the autumn wood having features, or we can say peculiar characteristics of a darker color and a high density that is present in a autumn wood, not in a spring one. So this is all for this question. Let's discuss the next one. The next question is, in monocots, vascular bundles are of closed type, what does it donate? When we consider the case of monocots, how the vascular bundles enact and what does it means of a closed type? First of all, on the basis of cotyledons, the plant is categorized into two main types, monocots and dicots. Monocots and dicots plants. It means the plants in which there is a cotyledons, or we can say no further bifurcation of a seed, or we can say fruit. For example, monocot is including wheat and maize. If we consider the case of dicot, in which the fruit, or we can say seed, is bifurcated into two, one, and the option or example for this is a pea plants. So, on the basis of cotyledons, it is categorized into two main plants, monocots and dicots. Again, in the case of monocots, vascular bundle, we all know vascular bundle include the we can say the following of a water and a mineral, or we can say the organic fruit from the root to the higher plants and the higher plants to the root, vice versa case, and it further including in the xylem and phloem. As we consider the case of a monocot plants, in monocot plants vascular bundles are categorized, or we can say that it is of closed type. Hence, if the vascular bundle is closed, is leading to the closing, or we can say the absence of a cambium. It leads to absence of cambium. Cambium is what? Cambium is a layer that generally present in between the xylem and the phloem and helps their flow, or we can say their function properly. So cambium is absent in a closed type of a vascular bundle, and vascular bundle is what? It further bifurcated into xylem and phloem. Xylem and phloem, both they in out of both, one is focused for the organic food, another is for the mineral, or we can say water, that is passing on from the root to the plants or higher plants, or we can say above the ground level and vice versa. So on that basis of this discussion, let's again discuss the question. The question is monocotes, vascular bundles are of closed type. What does it donate? There are four options. Option A includes xylem is surrounded by phloem. No. If we consider that monocotes, vascular bundles are of closed type. Vascular bundles, we all know, offer xylem and phloem. But if we consider the case of closed, it means there is an absence of a cambium. Hence, the xylem is not surrounded by the phloem. Option A is the wrong one. Option B is cambium is absent in the vascular bundle. Option C is the pores of a vessel elements and the sieve elements are closed. No, it not related to the pore or we can say vessel or elements, because as we consider the case of vascular bundles, it generally including the xylem and phloem, not to the vessel elements or we can say pores. Option D is a knot connection is between two successive internodes. No, there is an internal part, so internodes doesn't play any relevant role in the vascular bundle closing and opening type. So the option B is the right one. It means that cambium is absent in a vascular bundle when we consider the case of closed type. When we consider here the case of open type, then vascular bundle is present in a vascular bundle. We can say cambium is present in a vascular bundle only when we consider the case of open one, not the case of closed one. So option B is the right one in this case. That include that cambium is generally absent in the case of monocotes when they possesses the closed type of vascular bundle, not the open one. So option B is the right one in this case. Let's discuss the next one. Chlorenchyma is known to develop in. Now first of all, what is chlorenchyma? Chlorenchyma is a assimilatory parenchymatous tissue. Means that generally assimilate or we can say increase or we can say enhance the activity of a parenchyma cells, and that generally known to develop in. There are four options. Option A includes cytoplasm of a chlorella. Option B is a mycelium of a green mold such as aspergillus. Option C is a spore capsule of a moss, and option D is a pollen tube of a pinus. As we discussed that chlorenchyma is a assimilatory parenchymatous tissue. Parenchymatous tissue. These generally help in the parenchyma cells to elaborate, or we can say to provide the support to the pollen tube of a pinus plant, not the spore. Because as we consider the case of a chlorenchyma, there is a presence of a parenchymatous tissue, and parenchymatous tissue doesn't play any role in a spore capsule. So option C is the wrong one. Whereas the option B includes mycelium of a green mold. Mycelium are generally focused for the fungi, and aspergillus is again fungi, and chlorenchyma don't relate any property related to the fungi one, because this is not category of a plant one. Option A is the cytoplasm of a chlorella. This is also not the right one, so option A is also wrong. The right option for a question 4, that is a pollen tube of a pinus, is a chlorenchyma that developed in a pinus tree is the right one in this case. Let's discuss the next one. The next question is, which one of the following statement pertaining to plant structure is correct? Out of four, we have to check out the pertaining or we can say persistent correct statement for the plant structure. Option A is a cork lacks stomata but lentils carry out the transpiration. Option B is a passage cell help in a transfer of a food from cortex to phloem. Option C is a sieve tube elements possesses cytoplasm but not nuclei. Next is the option D includes the shoot apical meristem has a quiescent center. Option, first of all, according to the question, we have to answer the right one. The right answer in this question is option A. Why so? We have to check it one by one. The option D includes the shoot apical meristem has a quiescent center. When we consider the correct statement for the plant structure and quiescent center is that period out of which or a short lifespan or we can say short period the plant is going under